Welcome to Night Prayer with Father Matlack, your evening call to prayer. Pray with us every night, right here on the podcast and in your inbox. Learn more at goodcatholic.com/nightprayer.
As we end our day, let's do so in God's presence and begin our night prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Jesus Christ, my God, I adore you and thank you for all the grace you have given me this day. I offer you my sleep and all the moments of this night. I place myself and all my loved ones, wherever they may be, in your sacred side and under the mantle of our Blessed Mother. Let your holy angels stand watch and keep us in peace. Amen. One of the saints once said that if he came into the presence of an angel and a priest, he would still bow down to the priest before the angel, because that priest holds in his hands the sacred body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. And this is not to exalt myself. I certainly don't think myself as being holier than an angel, but it is a call and a reminder of just what has been given to me. Psalm 33 has a verse, "The angel of the Lord tarries round those that fear him, and he delivers them." The angels are always around us. They especially are around us in the Eucharistic presence of the Lord. We fear the Lord, we reverence the Lord, we come into his presence, and the angels guide us into his presence, because ultimately they desire for us to be forgiven and delivered from our sins. And if and when that happens, what does the next verse teach us? "Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusts in him." This is the goal of the angels. The goal of the angels is for us, ultimately, to taste and to see that the Lord is good. But we need to be delivered. We need to be forgiven. We need to be healed in order for us then to taste and see that the Lord is good. When we are sick, we've all had this experience of not being able to eat for a while as we heal. And sometimes the spiritual life is the same. And our guardian angels are very patient with us. And they're always calling us, seek the medicine of immortality. First, the healing medicine in sacred confession, and then the food of the angels, the immortal food, the food of the immortals, the body and blood of Christ, which makes us live forever. Now I invite you to examine your conscience. Firstly, give thanks to God for all the benefits that you have received this day. Secondly, ask God for the grace to know your sins and to be rid of them. Thirdly, take an account of all the sins that you have committed during this day, in thoughts, in words, and in deeds. Fourthly, ask pardon from the Lord for all the sins that you have committed. Finally, make a resolution with God's grace to amend your life. Finally, we end with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thanks for listening today. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Night Prayer with Father Matlack is a production of Good Catholic, the media division of The Catholic Company. For more faith-filled podcasts and videos, visit goodcatholic.com.